One of the things about childhood cancer is, yes, it's rare, fortunately, but I think what a lot of people don't understand is that after accidents and suicide, cancer is the leading cause of death in children in this country.
Unfortunately for certain families and patients, their first line of cancer treatment doesn't produce the results they desire. Either the treatment doesn't work, or it works momentarily and then the cancer comes back or progresses. In those cases, you have to use new and more experimental approaches, and those approaches are only available to very few centers in the country, and Mott Children's Hospital is one of the 20 centers which is part of what we call phase one center.
Children don't understand why they get cancer, and they don't understand why there's not a cure. I had a child diagnosed with neuroblastoma ask me quite directly, what causes neuroblastoma, and is there a cure? And that question changed my life. I decided to spend my life answering those questions.
You know, one of the frustrations for us in pediatric cancer research is it's woefully underfunded nationally relative to other diseases that perhaps are more common but happen in older patients. And so we struggle in the pediatric research community with trying to find funding for what is perceived in the greater community as being, well, these are rare tumors, why should we fund this research? And I think all you have to do is talk to any one of us or talk to any family or any child, and it's abundantly obvious why we should be funding this research.
Every 4 hours, a child dies with cancer. That's unacceptable to me. And so there is no doubt in my mind that we are going to make significant contributions to curing this disease.
I think that this is probably the most exciting time in cancer research for decades. We will radically change the way we treat cancer over the next 10 to 20 years because of the research that's being done today.